This is Knights Sports Network.
Pressure coming. Franklin cannot escape as he is wrapped up by Akeem Mezidor.
Waters, nowhere to go.
Look at him, keeping his shoulders square, work down that line as it caves down, and he just makes up his mind he's going to go make that play. One of the best rush ends in the nation, and he's been putting on a show for us the last couple weekends. It's fun to watch.
Akeem, a technician. Just one of those guys who's just going to come in and work hard every day. And when it's time to put it on display, he gonna bring it.
And here comes the blindside rush. The ball pops out. That might be ruled a fumble. I think it is.
But the plays made by Mezidor there, getting the football out. And then Taylor, 56, with a big man INT. And look, Miami fighting.
Uyunglele, blindside hit. And he is sacked back to the 16 by Akeem Mezidor.
From the 41, Wells was looking deep and the pocket folds in. Mezidor again, he is living in that backfield.
My name is Ajoa Joe, a wide receiver at Clearwater Academy.
Going to a Joe.
Oh, and a touchdown.
My name is Akeem Esler from Ottawa, Ontario.
Makes one miss. He's still going.
Touchdown!
Oh,
Jared Wayne.
What?
He jumps over.
I will continue my athletic career at the University of West Virginia.
Look how active he is.
I'll be continuing my grind at Clemson University.
Joe, take us back to when you scored your first career touchdown for Clemson. What was that play like?
This is a big young man now. 6'3", 210 pounds, violent. Finish.
What I love about Joe is watching his tape. And I mean, he's out there, he's tough. He loves football.
Only played 1 year of high school football down at Clearwater Academy International.
Sack for the Panthers.
Baldonado. Sack for the Pitt defense.
Pick it over the middle and a touchdown to Wayne.
And he's met and sent back by Sianofo Angatutoa.
Just the level of independence you have at Clearwater Academy International, it helps prepare you for a college environment.
This is Clearwater! Oh, oh, oh.
It's been really exciting to see all of our kids having success. A lot of our kids have come from around the world in the pursuit of getting a Division I scholarship, and we've had tons and tons of college scholarships from all around the country. It's so cool for our athletes to have that happen here.
Clearwater coaches are best, bro. This is like first day I moved down here, family.
The way they prep you for each game, week in and week out, it's like taking a test and you already know the answers.
They played a big role as mentors on and off the field.
Here, we keep it a priority to make sure our athletes are winning, not only on the field, but in the classroom. I think it's pretty awesome and it speaks for itself that we can get students from Italy, American Samoa, Germany, Norway, Spain, academically eligible for the next level. And we do that all here at Clearwater Academy.
It definitely prepared me well for college. The teachers give you great one-on-one time.
You have a really good academic program and it helps you get to where you need to be. In order for you to go to college and go to the next level.
First day I moved down here, like, boom, offer. And it was like, wait, what?
I've signed with the University of Pittsburgh,
Indiana University,
Western Carolina University,
Boise State.
Before I came to Clearwater Academy, I had zero offers.
How many offers do you have today?
I mean, I got Bama, Penn State, Auburn, FAU, and then I got Indiana, UCF. Iowa State, Iowa, Oregon, Clemson.
So I've been here for about like 14 years. Being a freshman and getting offers is a crazy feeling.
One of the things that sets us apart is our strength and conditioning program. I don't think there's a better strength and conditioning program in the country as far as high school football goes.
The team's training program at Clearwater Academy is like unbelievable. I came here at 196 and now I'm 215.
It helps you get bigger, stronger, faster. As you saw on my Twitter, I'm basically dunking a football now, so more athletic than ever.
We work heavily on injury prevention, flexibility, and things that are going to be beneficial to their long-term success and are really going to resemble what they are getting at the college level as well.
That is Ludovic Choquet.
I think he's gone.
He may be gone. Touchdown, nice. Oh. Play action, he's got somebody. That is one Williams. He's going to go all the way. Touchdown, nice.
All right, handoff goes to Barron. He has a lane.
Passes to a Joe. He jumps over the man. Give us to Ludovic.
And he's gone.
And he may go all the way. It's a foot race, and Ludovic is going to win that race. Touchdown.
The give is to
Brendan Barrow. What a run by Brendan Barrow. And he might go all the way.
This goes to Choquet.
And off is to Choquet.
He needs another block. Might have a chance here.
And Luca keeps the ball with a big run. Play action for Joe. He catches it. handoff is to Brendan Barrow, and he goes in. The handoff is to Ludovic. He finds the hole. What a move by Ludovic. He finds the corner.
He has a block downfield. And
what a run. He can go all the way. Touchdown, Knight. Looking to pass. Luke Dean.
He's got grass. He should
score. Might. Touchdown, Luke Dean.
Oh.
To 44. No, oh, a keeper. No snap. High pass. Good catch. But
oh, he's not gone.
Somehow.
Miracle play there.
By Luke Dean.
Hand off to Choquette. Breaks two tackles.
And he's still going.
Oh,
he's
my
he
gosh.
Is going to score. Touchdown. The pass.
Wow.
Keen Messidor.
Beautiful.
This is Knights.
No,
they are punting. Field it cleanly. Shakespeare Lewis. Shakespeare Lewis with a big run back. It's a keeper, Lucas.
Oh, he's
done. Give it to Ludovic. He has a first down and he has touchdown. Nice. Gives to B.J. Harris. Has a hole. Ball is loose. Covered by the Knights. That is Wesley Bill. Passing, not the win.
Very Theodore.
What a run by Ludovic Choquette.
Ludovic.
He has a break. Makes a cut. Great run by Ludovic Choquette. The ball is loose. The Knights say they have it. Knights ball. And it is Knights ball. Johari McGregor with the recovery. Looking to pass.
Oh, and he's open. And it's caught.
It's caught. And it's a he lost the ball. One Williams recovered it for the Knights. The give is to who else? Ludovic Choquette. And they are calling touchdown. Nice.
Give it to Brendan Barrow.
He finds a big one. Brendan Barrow still going. Still going. Brendan Barrow touchdown.
That is true.
Ohardo is set. That was our head coach, Jesse Chitstar, with a slide. The Knights are just going nuts.
Amazing.
The Knights are sliding. An absolute shocker. The Knights beat the very, very tough McCauley School. That's David Feldman on the ground.
Full birds on the loop.
From Chattanooga, Tennessee, KSM.
This is Knights Sports Network.
Time after time, I've done my sentence.
Yeehaw!
Howdy, Cowboys
and Cowgirls.
We're coming to you live from San Antonio, Texas.
Hand off is to John Carrington, and it was very well defended by Devontae Turner.
Say what it is, right?
General Booty passing to a big pass. He might go all the way.
Oh,
he loses the ball.
He got it.
Nice.
He got it.
Nice, nice recovery.
What a play.
We need a replay.
No way.
That was insane.
No. And look at that, 2 feet in. Actually, we only need one.
And who was that? Was that coach? That was
Pop.
Here goes Luca.
Oh, wow. Another big play. And he gets a great block and runs it for 65 yards.
Cornerstone Christian Warriors.
There goes Luca.
There goes Luca. Big run by Luca.
Woo!
And four. Hand off to Ludovic.
Here he goes.
Big hole. Touchdown. Luka looks to run it in himself for the Warriors from their own 42-yard line.
Wow.
Hand off again to John Carrington. Wow. Great pressure. Hand off again to Ludovic. And he breaks the tackle.
Oh, he's still going.
He's still going.
Oh,
come on down. 47-yard line. All right, we are on and live. Welcome to Sarasota, Florida, where tonight the Clearwater Academy Knights will take on another tough opponent, Riverview Sarasota High School. We will take on the Riverview Sarasota High School Rams. Sorry, I'm Jeff Feldman. We're very shorthanded tonight, so bear with us as we will try to bring you the best coverage. Last week, the Knights beat Gray Collegiate in a home game. It was homecoming and senior night, and the game was quite interesting. Featured a couple of trick plays with all 11 players strictly being seniors. There was even a Philly special with a pass going to Big Sean Civilano. But in all, there were too many turnovers, and you got to believe the Knights coaching staff has been emphasizing all week a cleanup on these errors. On the positive side, our defensive line was on fire, especially great play by Sean Civilano, Evan Aubrey, Sam Errett, Louis Giron, and I don't want to leave out Kiari James helping out from his linebacker position. Of course, Antoine Raymond had another impressive game. Just 180 yards on the ground, two touchdowns. Dallas Sims and Manny McKinney looked very good in the receiving department. And TJ Wilson got the KSN honors for Player of the Week with his two interceptions, including a pick six. You look over, if you are watching, you see on the screen that is the impressive band of Riverview Sarasota High School. Great band, remember them from last year. Knights did play Riverview last year, and we did win that game. Let's talk alumni, Clearwater Academy alumni were active, you know, all over this past week. Haba Baldonado, who's now in the CFL, looked very, very good. Greg Chiano is the former head coach for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and currently the head coach for Rutgers. He sent this to Jesse Chinchor, the CAI head coach this week. It was regarding Wesley Bailey, and he calls him the axe player of the game, but the note reads, Jesse, Wesley did an awesome job in our win versus Wagner. Our entire program thanks you and everyone at Clearwater Academy International. So something to make all the coaches proud. All right, let's talk a little bit about tonight's game. Our veteran, QB1, Evans Chuba, is still out. Quarterback duties, again, you can see him. He's in the middle of your screen, number 10.
They fall to freshman Joaquin Kavuklis. He's shown great promise. And if he can protect the ball, the Knights should do very well. And it's going to be important tonight to see him get some early completions, which could go a long way to stabilizing his rhythm and his pause. All right, let's talk a little bit about this team. As I said, we played them last year. It is Sarasota Riverview. We are in Sarasota, Florida. And these are the Sarasota Riverview Rams. They're extremely talented on both sides of the ball, including a number of Division I capable players. Their only loss this year, I've been asked, well, how good is this team? Their only loss this year is to the very highly ranked Venice High School. And by the way, in case Jonathan's watching, that's Venice, Florida, not Italy, Johnny. All right, talking about a couple of their players, their big quarterback, Braxton Thomas, that's number 7. He's somebody who's being actively recruited to Div 1 schools. He's a good scrambler and runner. Their backup quarterback, who's also a wide receiver, is Anthony Miller. He's number 14, and they're pretty common. Look for the trick plays from time to time where there's a handoff to Miller and then him turning around and passing the ball. Rams also sport a fairly good running back in DJ Johnson. He has number 0. All right, keys to tonight's game. The Knights are going to be intent on continuing the strong momentum that's been established over the last month after a very slow start. This means continued performance on first and second downs and avoiding the third and long. Riverview is very much geared up to stop the run, and they're definitely going to key in on our ground attack. So for CAI to prevail, we will need to figure out how to run against the Rams while also carrying out an effective aerial game. And for the Rams to win, they would need to somehow overcome the Clearwater Academy big, bad defensive line. Most of all, though, tonight the Knights really need to clean up the turnover mistakes, especially with special teams. And as usual, we just need to do what we do best, and that's simply playing Knights football. All right, I want to acknowledge our director of football operations, and that is Kanan Feshback. Without Kanan, I don't know how this program could possibly function. Our gold season sponsor is Brent Ellis and Legacy Claims. The official team sponsor is Bob Safail and his company, American Stories. Also an official team sponsor is Family Life Chiropractic. Family Life specializes in drug-free natural health care that allows their patients to be pain-free, strong, and healthy for life. Their doctors treat athletes, children, and adults and guide them to make rational health decisions. Their Dr. Philip is helping the Knights because they are the future generation and they need to be strong and healthy. Our lead season sponsor is Warren and Leanne Meyer. Official team sponsor, Johnson and Son Trucking. All pro sponsor, J.S. Perry. Also all pro sponsor, Dr. Renee Reed. MVP sponsor is the pirate ship, Captain Mimos. And here's this band playing. I hope you can hear me over the band. Team captain sponsors. Quarterback sponsors. All-star sponsors, thank you. And some more all-star sponsors. Team player sponsors. And some more team player sponsors. Knights fan sponsors. Some more Knights fan sponsors. And special thanks to the Knights supporters. And a special thank you to Coach Rich. Your legacy will live on through all of the players whose lives you've touched.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time I'd like to ask everyone to please rise.
And of course, a shout out to Miguel. Thank you.
At this time, Riverview High School and the Riverview football program.
You can become a sponsor of the Knights. Please go to our new website, that's caiknightsfootball.com, to sign up. CAI is a nonprofit school. We depend upon the generosity of our community to help fund the football program.
We ask at this time that you would please join us in a moment of silence in remembrance of Bo Christensen.
This is a special tribute. Thank you to Riverview there, to Coach Rich, and a moment of silence. That's for Rich Stubler of the Knights.
Thank you. Light Major Gregory Peck now leads in the traditional play of Amazing Grace.
All right, I'm going to show the Knights lineup video at this point. And here we go with that.
Jason Sandamela, Mozambique, Africa, center, committed to USC, Trench Mafia. Jason Sandamela, Mozambique, Africa, center, committed to USC, Trench Mafia, fight on.
Shane Diadakume, Edmonton, Alberta, 7'8", certified strapper.
Samuel Eric, Freiburg, Germany, defensive end.
Tavor Wilson from St. Petersburg, Florida, left 26.
Herschel Johal, offensive line, Vancouver, BC.
Sean Big Bear Civilano, defensive tackle, Winnipeg, Manitoba. Go Irish, baby.
Thomas Matt, offensive lineman, Montreal, Quebec, Trench Mafia.
Isaiah Hayes, offensive line, Clearwater, Florida, Trench Mafia.
Dallas Sims, Winnipeg, Manitoba, roll the boat.
Louis Donald, defensive line, Quebec, Canada.
Joaquin Cavacles, quarterback, Harbor Springs, Florida.
Mauricio Hines, Nova Scotia, Canada, guard, Trench Mafia.
Kai Johnson, class of 25, Harbor Springs, Florida, wide receiver DB.
Armand Leho, offensive line, Surrey, British Columbia, Canada, 604, Trench Mafia.
Edison Polo, aka Polo, Ottawa, Ontario, Gridiron Academy,
Shout out 613.
Anthony Popa, Clearwater, Florida, wide receiver.
Ami Brown, wide receiver, Clearwater, Florida.
David Amari, linebacker, Pack City, Canada.
Forrest Levin, safety, Clearwater, Florida.
Kane Fox, Rotterdam, the Netherlands. Also linebacker, DB.
Vito Shevchenko, offensive tackle, Vancouver, British Columbia, Trench Mafia.
Isaiah Thomas, from Toronto, Canada, safety, go Canes.
Jack Perry, kicker, Clearwater, Florida.
Gib Rosenda, left tackle, AG Alberta. Shout out Alberta Select, Trench Mafia.
Keyshawn Burks, cornerback, Clearwater, Florida, Seatbelt Boys.
Evans Chuba, quarterback, number 10, Montreal, Canada.
Brandon Kube, tight end, Winnipeg, Manitoba.
Dan Popa, wide receiver, Cincinnati, Ohio.
Kiari James, linebacker, Calgary, Alberta.
Shout out Smart Performance Football.
Antoine Irman, Montreal, Quebec.
Best in the nation.
Jida Sakala, defensive back, Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada.
Hara Kalai, St. Pierre, Florida, wide receiver.
Ludwig Martin, tight end, Montreal, Canada.
Ryan Hassett, linebacker, Calgary, Canada.
Manuel Manny McKinney, class of 2027, wide receiver slash athlete, Tampa, Florida. Let's go Knights.
Christopher Kresser, class of 26, Seatbelt Boys, Bushville, Florida.
Brody Kelchick, wide receiver, Windsor, Ontario.
Carlos Teklu, linebacker, Winnipeg, Manitoba.
Daniel Schilling, defensive lineman, Sterling, Virginia.
Tilo Moy, tight end, Norway.
Deshaun Davis, class of 26, offensive line, Trench Mafia.
Delano Blood, safety, Winnipeg, Manitoba, RRFM.
Khalid Campbell, running back, Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. Dilly Dilly, G-Squad made.
All right, we are back. Sorry about that, but while we were running the lineup video, they played the national anthem. But the band is continuing to play. We have about 10 minutes to go before the game starts. In the meantime, we'll let you just enjoy the music from the band.
Our referee this evening is Jim S. Umpire's first serve, our head line.
All right, Sakitza Feldman says, let's go Knights.
Scott Jacobs, our clock operator this evening, our guest Fritz, Gary Feldman. Also want to remind everybody that we'll have a special presentation coming up at the conclusion of the first quarter. So at the end of the first quarter, you're definitely going to want to pay attention down on the field as we have a big recognition coming up. Some very, very dedicated and some very, very deserving teachers coming up here this evening. I'd like to thank everybody for wearing pink tonight and supporting this with our Breast Cancer Awareness Month game. And remember that we've still got one more game coming up later this month, or one more home game that we'll take on the Sailors coming up on Friday night, October the 27th. And that will be a very, very special night as we will officially dedicate the field to Ram legend head coach John Spring. So on October the 27th, this historic facility will be forever known as the Ram Bowl at John Sprague Field. So don't want to miss the big rivalry game coming up on Friday, October the 27th, when the Rams take on the Sailors. The concession stand is open, located both at the west and east end of the stadium. Riverview High School Guilty Band would like to remind everybody that coming up on November the 4th...
One thing I've just been notified of is that the clock on our broadcast is not properly syncing up with the scoreboard, so you will not see the clock. We'll try to regularly update you on the time remaining.
For the coin toss, captains this evening for Clearwater International.
Announcing the captains for the coin toss. That's Joaquin Cavucles, Gary James, Jason Zandamella, and Sean Civilano. That was left to right. The weather for tonight's game is 82. Should stay around 80 throughout the game. We actually have some colder weather rolling into Florida, but unfortunately that's not until tomorrow or Monday. We're getting a real cold snap. This will make some of you, our cold snap. We're going to get down actually where the highs aren't going to even reach 70 in the next few days.
Captain this evening for the Rams, number 7, Braxton Thomas. Number 10, Henry Pioriglio. Number 34, Chase Caldwell. And number 55, Weston Purgatorio.
They're just calling off the captains now for the Rams. We're going to meet at midfield and have the coin toss. All right, so the toss was won by Riverview, but they elected strategically not to receive. Instead, they want to receive in the second half. So the Knights will receive the kick. Steve Bazio says, let's go Knights. Hi, Steve. It's also homecoming for Riverview, Sarasota. And they're ready to come on the field, the Rams.
Get ready to make some noise and get up on your feet.
All right, man. Here they come, Riverview Rams. With that band playing, just fantastic. Kai Johnson and Manny McKinney back to receive the kickoff for the Knights. Mackay is number two, Manny is number four. And we're ready to get this game underway. Somehow there's a flag. Okay, he's pointing to Riverview. I didn't understand it was a delay of game, but he pointed towards the Knights, but the delay of game is actually on the Rams. They're going to lose 5 yards and start over. All right, here's the kickoff. an onside kick. And Riverview recovers the ball. Here's the replay on this onside kick. First and 10 for the Rams inside Knights territory. A little bit of a flea flicker, incomplete. Well defended by T.J. Wilson, was not fooled by that flea flicker at all. Second and 10. A handoff, well defended by the Knights, got a couple. Well, they spotted that further than I saw. Third and 7 now. That's offsides on the Knights. That's going to give the Rams a short third down. Now third and 2. And that is a first down, Rams. And Sapphire McKay wanted me to explain what a little bit of a flea flicker is. The quarterback handed it off to the running back, and then he flipped it back to the quarterback, who then threw the ball. That is a flea flicker. First and 10, Rams. Run. Big, strong run for first down, 9 yards by the Rams. Second and 1. Riverview showing a very nice rhythm here to start this game. Another handoff. And he slid, or would have gotten more. That is a first down. Rams now in the red zone. That's inside the 20. Hand off. Well defended. There is a flag. Looks to be offensive holding. This ref doesn't know his right from his left, but it is a offensive holding. They're going to repeat first down now, first and 20. We'll see what kind of play the Rams dial up now. All right, looking to pass, and it is incomplete. Second down. Now there's 9 minutes left in the first quarter. We apologize. The clock is not syncing tonight. Big run, 15 yards. We said that this quarterback, Braxton Thomas, is a good runner. He's showing it now, third and six. Third and six. Looking to pass. Almost picked off. Incomplete. Rams in a with a field goal opportunity, bringing on the kicking team. This kick will be from 31 yards. All right, it's up and it is good. All right, Rams draw first blood, up 3-0. Knights defense did buckle down eventually to force the field goal as opposed to giving up a touchdown after losing the ball to the onside kick. That is Makai Johnson and Manny McKinney back deep. We'll see what the Rams try. We'll see if they try another onside kick.
31 in the rear on the kick to the rim.
And he kicks it deep this time. Caught at the five. That's Mekhi Johnson with a big run back. Still going. And the Knights offense finally making an appearance after that great run back by Mekhi Johnson. First and 10 for the Knights. Great field position. Hand off Antoine Raymond. Finds the edge. Great run by Antoine Raymond. Here's that kickoff. That great return by Mekhi Johnson.
First and 10 Knights from the 20.
First and 10 now for the Knights. Looking to pass, complete. That is Mekhi Johnson. There is a flag. See what that's about. Yeah, the Knights had an ineligible receiver downfield. That is going to be a 5-yard penalty. First and 15 now. Hand off Antoine Raymond. Very well defended by the Rams. Second and 18 now. Looking at pass. He's got Mekhi Johnson. Touchdown.
Pass over the middle is caught. How about number two, Mekhi Johnson for the Knights touchdown.
Knights going for the extra point. It is Alessandro Galantini for the attempt. That is up and it is good.
The extra point is up and good for number 47, Alessandro Galantini. 7:04 to go in the first quarter. It's now Knights 7, Rams 3.
Here's this touchdown pass. What a great throw by Joaquin Kavouklis. Great grab by Mekhi Johnson. Mekhi Johnson did everything on this entire offensive set, from the great run back on the kickoff all the way through to the touchdown. Knights now have the advantage, 7-3. Yeah, time check is 7 minutes left in the first quarter. Sorry, those that were late to the broadcast. Our clock is not syncing up with the scoreboard clock tonight. Jack Perry with the kickoff. And Jack's kicking it deep this time. Big kick, and it is a touchback. Didn't know Jack had that kind of leg. Rams will take over now, first and 10 from their own 20. First and 10 now for the Rams. Couple of yards. Second and 8 now. Pass, and no gain, actually a loss. Third and 9 now. 6 minutes left in the first quarter. Looking to pass, complete, first down, Rams. Quarterback trying to fix the running back's equipment there. It is a handoff to him. No wonder he was fixing the equipment. Good block. Nice run on first down for 5 yards, 6 yards. Second and 4. Empty backfield for the Rams. Doesn't mean they're not running. Braxton Thomas, as we said, is a good runner. But he did attempt a pass incomplete. And Julie Malazola says, go Knights. That's from her mom and her grandmother from Chicago. Third and 4 now. Hand off. And that is going to be a first down, Rams.
45-yard line, and
There is a timeout on the field. That's a water break. There is 4 minutes, 54 seconds left in the first quarter. When we resume, Riverview will have first and 10 from their own 45-yard line. And so far they've been running the ball very well against the Knights, which is surprising because very few teams have had running success against the Knights this year. Looking to pass, Sean Civilano. Kieri Samuel Errett, Louis Ginron, all in there on the sack. Big loss for the Rams, second and 20. This time handoff. You had the same grouping in there led by Sean Civilano. No gain on the play. Small gain. Third and 17. Looking to pass, big pass, and somehow or another it was caught. Looked like it might get picked, but it is complete. Huge play for the Rams. First and 10 now inside the Knights' 20-yard line. Quarterback keeper. Nice gain. First down, 4 or 5 yards. Hand off to the running back. Good run inside the 5 yard line. Gonna show you that huge pass again. Hand off again. Touchdown Rams. All right, Rams with the extra point, and it is good. Well, a great offensive series by Riverview, resulting in a touchdown. Rams in the lead now, 10-7. Here's the kick, and fielded by Manny McKinney, and he is tackled at the 17-yard line. A minute and 42 seconds left in the first quarter. Knights got to work on offense. First and 10 from their own 17. Hand off. That was Khalid Campbell with the run. Second and 4, good run on first down. Looking to pass, complete, Makai Johnson. First down, Knights. Hand off. Khalid Campbell with another strong run on first down. Second and 6. Looking to pass. And that is picked off by the Rams. It's also a flag. I'm not sure what the flag was. It is a personal foul against the Knights. Must have hit them late out of bounds. That is 15 yards. Gonna bring the Rams deep into Knights territory. 33-yard line, 1st and 10. Inside the Knights 35, 1st and 10 Riverview. Strong defense this time by Kiari James. second and nine, and that's going to conclude the first quarter.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you make your turn your attention now to the field, today the 32 seniors on the roster celebrated the first annual Riverview Football Teacher Staff Recognition Day by recognizing the following individuals for their tireless dedication in the classroom and impacting the players' lives in a meaningful and positive way to further prepare each of them for the future. In doing so, they are recognized here tonight, and we're honored to be able to wear the players' respective jerseys throughout the day and tonight. Bradley Weller recognizing Heidi Lynn, Jackson Watrowski for Michael McGuckin, Anthony Campbell for Anthony Campbell Sr., Olive LaVenture for Marcy Paul, TJ Smith for Travis Smith, Drain Mitchell for Emily Waffles, Braxton Thomas for Brody Wiseman, Jason Evans for Rob Dragich, DeCorey Denrow for Blair Perry, Henry Fioriglio for Rebecca Heinz, Luke Haskins for Vicky Hosmer, Brandon King for Caitlin Bauer, Majestic Van Ingen for Sarah Hughes, Jeremiah Dawson for Alexander Lichter, Nick Sinicor for Mark Cristiani, Cooper Dotson for Vanessa Sanchez, Brayden Lenz for Rebecca Quinn, Jack Richard for Kim Johnson, Daniel Friere for Donald Basler, Lincoln States for Gabrielle Wasserman, Chase Caldwell for Elizabeth Bonino, Mike Theodore for Ashley Hernandez, Oliver Hunter for A.J. Brown, Jack Fulvig for Jason Mockerman, Malik Bird for Jessica Curtis, Weston Crudidoria for Brad Holderbeck, Josiah Williams for Mike Crudidoria, Julius Edwards for Allison Berry, Richard Wynn.
All right, Hunter, getting ready to start the second quarter now. Rams have great field position. It'll be second and nine when they resume.
That have been recognized by our senior football players here tonight. Thank you for the contributions that you have made to all of our student athletes.
Off big hole.
Second and nine. The Rams handed off to number 23.
Good gain.
Taken down by number 11, Kiari James.
Third and three now. Kiari James on the tackle. Another handoff. It is going to be very close to a first down. Depends where they spot it. And they are spotting it short. Fourth and less than a yard. Got to think they're going for this. Hand off. He does have the first down.
DJ Johnson taken down inside the 20-yard line by number 11, Kiari James.
Kiari James on the tackle again.
First down.
First and 10 Rams. So far the Rams have had little trouble moving it against the Knights on the ground. Really just one very long pass that the Rams have mixed in there, which led to their last touchdown. Looking to pass. There is a flag usually in the area of pass interference.
I believe they're going to call it a PI on that. That was a call that I would not make about it.
They're actually calling it holding. Might have been committed prior to the ball being in the air.
Penalty will be half the distance to the goal. It looks like we're looking at a very rare first and one.
Looks like first and a long one. They can yet pick up a first down without scoring here. Hand off.
And DJ
tripped up.
Ripped up. And he's going to get right to about the 7-yard line.
It is going to probably, it is a first down, Rams. First and goal.
Move the chains, good enough. Wherever you first down, first and goal, Rams.
About 10 minutes to go in the half. Another handoff, another big hole.
Johnson, he'll get down to the 1-yard line, pick up a 6 on the play. It'll be
big,
second and goal.
Big run on first and goal to the inside the 2-yard line. Second and goal. Quarterback kept it.
He's going to stop just shy of the goal line. Will be about a yard short.
Tackled just short of the end zone.
Going to bring up third and goal. So Thomas will have to come off for a play. So
third and goal now. Another handoff. Touchdown, Rams. Rams going for the extra point. It's up and it is good.
Good. 9:42 to go in the second quarter. Rams 17. Clearwater International Academy
17-7. Rams with a 10-point lead. You can see the time on your screen, 9:42 left in the half. Manny McKinney and Makai Johnson back deep to receive this kickoff. Last time, Makai Johnson had a huge run back. Let's see what happens this time. Manny McKinney fielding it. And gets across the 30, but there's a flag.
Must be a holding penalty against
It's a hold actually a block in the back by the Knights.
Actually, that'll be a block in the back penalty.
Brings it back to the 17-yard line.
17-yard line. Get this next drop, first and 10.
Knights take over, first and 10. Hand off. Very well defended. That was Antoine Raymond with the run.
Henry Fioriglio, gain of 2 on the play, second and 8.
Picked up a couple, second and 8. Pass. Complete. Dallas Sims. Third and 4.
That'll bring up third down. It'll be third down and 4.
8.5 minutes left in the half. Antoine Raymond takes the handoff. Close to a first. They're marking it as a first down.
We'll have enough for a first down for the Knights.
First and 10 now, Knights.
And Griffiths, number 20, making the shot for the Rams.
Brandon Coupe, nice pass all the way to practically to midfield. Rams are calling a timeout here. Seven minutes, 50 seconds left in the half. Here's this last play pass to Brandon Coupe. Well set up by the Knights. Low snap. Antoine Raymond somehow or another makes a positive play out of it. Second and 5. Empty backfield now. Antoine Raymond is split out in the slot. Pass for Makai Johnson, incomplete. Third and 4 now for the Knights. Manny McKinney in motion. Passing, going deep. incomplete to Manny McKinney.
Quick announcement, housekeeping item. If you have found a red phone, could you please return it to the front ticket booth?
Knights now in a tough situation. Fourth and four. Looks like they are leaving the offense on the field. Not going to be punting. And they are going for it. And Riverview is taking a timeout. And that is their final timeout.
Festivities and the field dedication. Legendary Ram head coach John Sprint.
7 minutes left in the half, as you could see.
Forever known as the Ram Bowl at John Sprint Field. Don't miss it. Join us Friday, October 27th, when the Rams take on the Taylor.
Looks like the Knights are still going for it. Not bringing on a punting team. Fourth and four. See what they have dialed up. Hand off Antoine. Raymond has the first down. He's still going. Goes out of bounds across the 35-yard line. Big run for Antoine Raymond when it was most needed by the Knights. There's 7 minutes left in the half. Going to pass. It is to Makai Johnson. And he gets to the 20. First and 10 Knights. Hand off. Antoine Raymond, there is a flag. That's a holding call. It is against the Knights. Now it is first and 20. Empty backfield. They're going to call a false start on Antoine Raymond. Knights digging a hole for themselves now. First and 25. Looking to pass. He's got Makai Johnson, is incomplete. There's 6 minutes and 15 seconds left in the half. Knights have second and 25. Looking to pass off the hands of Manny McKinney. Incomplete. Third and 25 now for the Knights. Manny McKinney with the pass. Gets back a lot. And now it is fourth and three. And it looks like we are going to kick.
They don't have another timeout. That's their last. That's four timeouts.
Rams are taking a timeout. Our coaches are saying that they're out of timeouts, but obviously the refs do not agree. Refs talking this over, but nevertheless, the Knights are going for a long field goal, 40-yard attempt, trying to bring this into a one-score game. All right, it's up, and it is no good. Five and a half minutes left in the half.
And we'll have timeout on the field as we are midway through the quarter for our water break. We'd like to take this time to welcome everybody to Homecoming 2023. We'd like to welcome back all
of the Knights had a very good drive going. Ran into some penalties, which killed the drive. Then tried a 40-yard field goal and missed.
Their own one.
Rams take over from the 20-yard line, first and 10. It's a handoff. Strong run. Knights have not been able to slow up this Rams run. That's a first down, 25 yards on the carry. Hand off. And he is a strong runner. Knights have a hard time bringing him down. Second and seven. Second and three. A good defensive stop this time by the Knights. Loses a yard. Third and four. Handoff, and that is probably a first down, and it is. First and 10 for the Rams. He's looking to pass, going long, incomplete.
Looking for Campbell.
Well defended again by T.J. Wilson. Hand off. Another big run by the Rams. Tackled by Delano Glad. First down, Rams. Hand off. Whistle blows. That is an official timeout for a player on the field that was injured. There's 2 minutes and 50 seconds left in the half. Sorry if you joined us late. Explain that the clock is not syncing up to the The clock is not syncing up with the scoreboard tonight, so we'll try to keep alerting you on the time. 2 minutes, 50 seconds left in the half. First and 10 now, Rams. Hand off. Another good run on first down. Second and five now. A loss on that play.
Dawson had the ball, and it looks like his knee came down at the 31.
Third and nine now.
Third down, the third and nine.
2 minutes and 13 seconds left in the half. Hand off. That is Delano Glad, who somehow penetrated well into the Riverview backfield. Here's this big tackle by Delano Glad again. You have Makai Johnson back to receive this punt. And he drops it. Recovered by the Rams.
Jason Evans making another great special teams play tonight.
Knights turn over the ball. Terrific field position now for Riverview. First and 10 from their own 15. There is a minute 7 left in the half. And that's going to be a flag on the Knights. They are offsides.
And that will be encroachment on the defense. 5 yard penalty, still first down, and it'll be first and five.
5 yards, so they're on the 10 yard line, that is first and five, with 1 minute and 30 seconds left on the clock.
First and five now for Riverview.
Thank you.
Handoff.
Handoff, DJ Clinton!
They are actually marking him out just short of the goal line.
A penalty flag is down.
There is a penalty flag.
And this one is coming back. Maybe a penalty against the Rams, a holding penalty.
It is a holding call against the Rams.
First down and
10
from the 15.
First and 10 now. Handoff. 5 yards. Second and 5.
Back near the 11, so pick up a 4. It's going to be second.
Clock is running now, below a minute. The Rams have no more timeouts. Another handoff, tackled.
Ball carrier, pick up a 3.
Third and 2 now.
Third down and 2.
And this time it is a first down.
That's going to move the chains. Good enough for Riverview.
20 seconds now left on the clock. First and goal. And the quarterback spikes it to stop the clock.
Second and goal from the 4.
20 seconds on the clock. The Rams could try to pass the ball. He is looking to pass. Just through the hands of the receiver, incomplete. Says third and goal. It should be second and goal, though, but it really doesn't matter. Matter of the time on the clock at this point, most likely. Looking to pass again. Incomplete.
Number 14, Anthony Miller. That'll bring up fourth down.
They are calling fourth down, but they're bringing in the field goal unit now.
Benning and on to attempt a 21-yard field goal from the right hash.
That's up, and it is good.
And it is good. And with 10 seconds to go here in the first half, it's now Rams 20, Titans 7.
And also now brings the score 20-7.
Just a reminder that coming up here at halftime tonight, you'll see.
There's 10 seconds left on the clock. I don't suppose that's enough time for the Knights to really do anything. We'll see if they try any kind of trick play on this kickoff return. Here's the kickoff.
Short kick fielded by the Knights.
Knights field it, go out of bounds around the 33-yard line. And as somebody points out here on the chat, I did miss the spike. That's right. That was the first down, was the spike. We'll see if the Knights looks like the Knights are just taking a knee.
And Knights will take a knee, and that will take us to halftime.
And that will wrap up the first half. All right, let's take a look at take a look at some of the highlights. Just getting these highlights ready for you. We from the first half. These highlights are sponsored by Bob Safail and his company, American Stories. They're also sponsored by Brent Ellis and Legacy Claims, Family Life Chiropractic, Warren and Leanne Meyer, as well as Johnson and Son Trucking. Here is the onside kick recovery. And this was the very long pass by the Rams. This was the touchdown to Makai Johnson. And this was the very good run back by Makai Johnson. And we saw that one already. All right, so rough first half for the Knights, down 13 points. Obviously, there's a lot to talk about at halftime. Knights need to figure out some points in the game. We're going to take a break. We're going to play you some highlights in the meantime, and we'll see you in the second half. First, this tribute to Coach Rich.
Pressure coming. Franklin cannot escape as he is wrapped up by Akeem Mezidor.
Waters Nowhere to go.
Look at him, keeping his shoulders square, work down that line as it caves down, and he just makes up his mind he's going to go make that play. One of the best rush ends in the nation, and he's been putting on a show for us the last couple weekends. He's fun to watch.
Keen, a technician. Just one of those guys who's just going to come in and work hard every day, and when it's time to put it on display, he's going to bring it.
And here comes the blindside rush. The ball pops out. That might be ruled a fumble. I think it is.
But the play's made by Mesidor there, getting the football out, and then Taylor, 56, with a big man INT, and look, Miami fighting.
Uyunglele, blindside hit, and he is sacked back to the 16 by Akeem Mesidor.
From the 41, Wells was looking deep, and the pocket folds in. Mesidor again, he is living in that backfield.
Thank you. Mitchell, a wide receiver at Clearwater Academy.
Going to a Joe.
Oh, and a touchdown.
My name is Akeem Mesler from Ottawa, Ontario.
Makes one miss.
He's still going.
Touchdown!
Jared Wayne.
What?
He jumps over.
I will continue my athletic career at the University of West Virginia.
Look how active he is.
I'll be continuing my grind at Clemson University.
Joe, take us back to when you scored your first career touchdown for Clemson. What was that play like?
This is a big young man now. 6'3", 210 pounds, violent. Finish.
What I love about a Joe is watching his tape. And I mean, he's out there, he's tough. He loves football.
Only played 1 year of high school football down at Clearwater Academy International.
Sack for the Panthers. Baldonado.
Sack for the Pitt defense.
Pick it over the middle and a touchdown to Wayne.
And he's met and sent back by Sianofo Angatutoa.
Just the level of independence you have at Clearwater Academy International, it helps prepare you for a college environment.
This is Clearwater! Oh, oh, oh.
Ball, ball, ball. It's been really exciting to see all of our kids having success. A lot of our kids have come from around the world in the pursuit of getting a Division I scholarship, and we've had tons and tons of college scholarships from all around the country. It's so cool for our athletes to have that happen here.
Clearwater coaches are best, bro. This is really like, first day I moved down here, family.
The way they prep you for each game, week in and week out, it's like taking a test and you already know the answers.
They played a big role as mentors on and off the field.
Here, we keep it a priority to make sure our athletes are winning, not only on the field, but in the classroom. I think it's pretty awesome and it speaks for itself that we can get students from Italy, American Samoa, Germany, Norway, Spain, academically eligible for the next level, and we do that all here at Clearwater Academy.
It definitely prepared me well for college. The teachers give you great one-on-one time.
You have a really good academic program, and it helps you get to where you need to be in order for you to go to college and go to the next level.
First day I moved down here, like, boom, offer. And it was like, wait, what?
I've signed with the University of Pittsburgh.
Indiana University.
Western Carolina University.
Boise State.
Before I came to Clearwater Academy, I had zero offers.
How many offers do you have today?
I mean, I got Bama, Penn State, Auburn, FAU, and then I got Indiana, UCF. Iowa State, Iowa, Oregon, Clemson.
So I've been here for about like 14 years. Being a freshman and getting offers is a crazy feeling.
One of the things that sets us apart is our strength and conditioning program. I don't think there's a better strength and conditioning program in the country as far as high school football goes.
The team's training program at Clearwater Academy is like unbelievable. I came here at 196 and now I'm 215.
It helps you get bigger, stronger, faster. As you saw on my Twitter, I'm basically dunking a football now. So more athletic than ever.
We work heavily on injury prevention, flexibility, and things that are going to be beneficial to their long-term success and are really going to resemble what they are getting at the college level as well.
That is Ludovic Choquette.
I think he's gone.
He may be gone. Touchdown, nice. Oh. Play action, he's got somebody. That is one Williams. He's going to go all the way. Touchdown, nice.
All right, handoff goes to Barrow. He has a lane.
Passes to a Joe. He jumps over the man. Give us to Ludovic.
And he's gone.
And he may go all the way. It's a foot race, and Ludovic is going to win that race. Touchdown.
The give is to
Brendan Barrow. What a run by Brendan Barrow. And he might go all the way.
This goes to Choquette.
And off is the Choquette.
He needs another block. Might have a chance here.
And Luca keeps the ball with a big run. Play action. for it, Joe. He catches it. Handoff is to Brendan Barrow. And he goes in. The handoff is to Ludovic. He finds the hole. What a move by Ludovic. He finds the corner.
He has a block downfield.
What a run. He can go all the way. Touchdown, nice.
Looking to pass.
Luke Dean.
He's got grass.
He
should score.
Might. Touchdown, Luke Dean. To 44. No, a keeper. No snap. High pass. Good catch. But
oh, he's not gone.
Somehow.
Miracle play there.
By Luke Dean.
Hand off to Choquette. Breaks two tackles.
And he's still going.
Oh,
he's
my gosh.
He is going to score. Touchdown. The pass.
Wow.
Keen Messidor.
Beautiful.
This is Knights.
They are
punting. Fielded cleanly. Shakespeare Lewis. Shakespeare Lewis with a big run back.
He's
a keeper. Lucas
Cassetti.
Give it to Ludovic. He has a first down and he has touchdown. Nice. Give it to B.J. Harris. Has a hole. Scores loose. Covered by the Knights. That is Wesley Bill. Passing, not the win.
Very Theodore.
What a run by Ludovic Choquette.
Give it to Ludovic.
He has a crease. Makes a cut. Great run by Ludovic Choquette. The ball is loose. The Knights say they have it. Knights ball. Give it to Ludovic, and he falls over, and he's still going.
And that's my
And it is Knights ball. Johari McGregor with the recovery. Looking to pass.
Oh, and he's open. And it's caught.
It's caught. And it's a fumble. He lost the ball. Wanda Williams recovered it for the Knights. The give is to who else? Ludovic Choquette, and they are calling touchdown. Nice.
Give
it
to
Brendan Barrow. He finds a kickoff. Brendan Barrow still going. Still going. Brendan Barrow touchdown.
That is true.
Ohardo is set. That was our head coach, Jesse Chitstar, with a slide. The Knights are just going nuts.
Amazing.
The Knights are sliding. An absolute shocker. The Knights beat the very, very tough college school. That's David Feldman on the ground.
Full birds on the loop.
From Chattanooga, Tennessee, KSN.
This is Knights Sports Network.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence.
Yeehaw! Howdy, Cowboys!
And Cowgirls.
We're coming to you live from San Antonio, Texas.
Handoff is to John Carrington, and it was very well defended by Devontae Turner. General Booty passing to Big Pat. He might go all the way.
Oh!
He loses the ball.
He got it.
Nice.
He got it.
Nice recovery.
What a play.
We need a replay.
No way.
That was insane.
No.
Hard. And look at that, 2 feet in. Actually, we only need one.
And who was that? Was that Coach? That was Pop.
Here goes Luca.
Oh, wow. Another big play. And he gets a great block and runs it for 65 yards.
This is Knights Sports Network.
All right, we are getting ready for the second half in a couple of minutes. In the meantime, I want to point you in the direction of youtube.com/Knights Sports Network. And that's where you can subscribe to us. Just click the subscribe button. Be sure to click on the alert bell. Allow your phone to alert you whenever we go live. Twenty-to-7. Mostly the Rams' offense in the first half. Knights' defense was on the field quite a bit. There were at least 3 turnovers, a dropped punt, an interception, and an onside kick recovery by the Rams. Gary Johnson says, okay, Knights, it's time to play Knights football. That's for sure. The Knights will be kicking off to start the second half. Looks like this time it'll be Jita Sinkala to do the kickoff duties for the Knights.
Out to kick for Clearwater International Academy will be number 13, Jita Sinkala.
All right, starting the second half, big kick into the end zone. That'll be a touchback. First and 10 from the 20 for Riverview.
If anyone has located a drink
If you're first joining us for the second half, we are not able to sync up with the clock on the scoreboard. We'll try to update you on the time handoff. Another good first down run by the Rams. 5 yards. Second and five. Hand off. Kiari James meets him. He actually shoved him to the ground. Kiari James, a little bit lucky they did not throw a roughing flag on that play. Third and five now. Delano Glad was threatening to blitz. He is passing. It is incomplete. Looks to be broken up by C.J. Kresser. And Rams in an obvious punting situation now. Good defensive set this time for the Knights. Whatever adjustment they made at halftime, for the moment, seems to be working. Makai Johnson back to receive, goes over his head, and he fielded it anyway, rather dangerously.
Pin the Knights back at the 23-yard line.
But he held on to the ball. First and 10 Knights. A very good punt for Riverview. Hand off, Antoine Raymond picks up a few. Second and six. Pass, Makai Johnson. First down. Hand off Antoine Raymond. There is a flag, usually in the area of holding. It is holding against the Knights.
Quick announcement, Evan, if you have lost your debit card, please come to the concession stand. Evan, if you've lost your debit card, they have it at the concession stand. And a reminder that we've got plenty of Chick-fil-A sandwiches and slices of pizza available at the concession stand.
First and 20 now for the Knights. Antoine Raymond with a short gain. Second and 18 now. Nine and a half minutes left in the third quarter. Pass, Dallas Sims. Big play, cross midfield. Third and one now for the Knights. Antoine Raymond with the first down. Knights now in Rams territory, their 47-yard line, first and 10. Reverse, Dallas Sims. Cross the 40. Little bit of trickery by the Knights. Second and one. Pass. Manny McKinney. Complete. Knights showing some rhythm now. Cross the 31st and turn 10, 8 minutes and 10 seconds left in the third quarter. Hand off Antoine Raymond, gets through the first. Big run by Antoine Raymond. But the ball was lost and recovered by the Rams. Fourth turnover now for the Knights. It was a great run by Antoine Raymond. Here is this play again with Antoine Raymond. Ball was punched out very alertly by the Rams. Great recovery. There's a run. Missed tackle. There is a flag. All right, they are waving the flag. Don't know what that was about. Second and two. It's a run, and that is a first down, Rams. Hand off, another good run. S- Second and five. Seven minutes left in the third quarter. Another run. Knights having a hard time bringing the Rams down. It's going to be very close to a first down. And they are marking it. We'll see. And they are moving the chains. First and 10 Rams. Now driving from their own 44-yard line. Quarterback keeper. He has a big hole. He could go all the way. Touchdown, Rams.
To the house. Touchdown, Rams. No flags. Yard touchdown run for the Rams QB. Designating it on to attempt the extra point. Aiden Rennick will snap. Nick Telfow to hold.
Here's the extra point that is up and good.
It is good with 6:04 to go in the third quarter. Rams 27, Knights 7.
Here is this touchdown quarterback keeper. That is Braxton Thomas of Riverview.
6 minutes, 4 seconds. Third quarter. Your team has 3 seconds.
Well, now a 20-point lead by the Rams.
And over here on the kick for the Rams.
Knights need to get busy at this point, or are they going to be pricing themselves out of this game? We'll see if the Rams go deep or try another onside. And they are going deep. And Makai Johnson fields it in the end zone. That is a touchback. Knights take over. First and 10 for their own from their own 20. Khalid Campbell with the carry, picks up 7 yards, nice run on first down. Second and three now. intended for Manny McKinney, incomplete. 5 minutes, 30 seconds left in the third quarter. Third and three for the Knights. Hand off to Khalid Campbell. Close to a first down, marking him, I believe, just short. We'll see. Fourth and short. Knights look to be going for this. Khalid Campbell, big run.
Campbell will pick up the first down.
First down and a lot more. First and 10 now for the Knights. Pass. Almost picked off. Seemed to be a bit of a mix-up on that receiving pattern. Second and 10. Going deep for Dallas Sims, overthrows him. Third and 10 now. Antoine Raymond, great run, first down, cross midfield now. Big third down run by Antoine. First and 10 for the Knights. Intended for Brandon Kube, incomplete. Screenplay, great play by Antoine Raymond. Hand off Antoine Raymond. Touchdown Knights.
Call me,
field goal team.
Take this time to thank our sponsors and supporters of Riverview Rams football, Above Par Capital, Allstate Insurance, Aqua Plumbing and Air, Coast to Coast Pool, Eco Clear Products, Fifth Best Center for Physical Medicine, and Mullet Delivery Products. Sideline sponsors this year, the Glory Days Grill, Wise Construction, HDA Florida, Sarasota Doctors Hospital, Eco Clear Products.
All right, here's the kickoff. It is an onside kick.
An onside kick attempt for Clearwater Academy International, and it looks like the Rams have recovered. Rams will start at the 35.
They're saying Rams do recover the onside. Here's this touchdown by Antoine Raymond. Four minutes left in the third quarter. Hand off. Tackled by Kerry James. Second and 7. Another handoff. Tackled out of bounds. Three-ten. Time left in the third quarter, 3 minutes and 10 seconds. Third and 4. And that is going to be a first down Rams. Big run for the Rams. First down. Two minutes left now in the third quarter.
Time is 2 minutes and running.
Big hole again.
Isaiah felt the ball carrier thrown out.
First down, Rams.
Once again, that'll move the chains. Get it up for Riverview. First down. Gina Sincala to stop for the Knights. First and 10 Rams.
First and 10.
Rams taking their time now. They feel like the clock is definitely on their side. Hand off. Sean Civilano with a big stop.
Civilano. No gain on the point. Second and 10 coming up.
Second and 10. We'll see if they get off a play before the end of the third quarter. And they do hand off.
And they'll hand it off to Belt, and he'll be taken down just shy of the 20-yard line. Rams will not have to run another play here in the third quarter. So the clock will wind down and hit zero.
That is the end of the third quarter.
27, 14.
That is the end of the third quarter.
Don't forget, the Rams going to be on the road next Friday night. They'll head up to Manatee High School to take on the Manatee Hurricanes at Hawkins Stadium. Joe Canan Field coming up next Friday night, kickoff at 7:30. But be back here at the Ram Bowl Friday night, October the 27th. This is going to be a big one. Rams taking on the Crosstown Rivals, Sarasota Steelers. And prior to the game, we
all right, we move into the fourth quarter. Rams ahead 13 points and driving. It is third and 5. That is a false start on the Rams. A good defensive play here could make a field goal very difficult for them. Looking to pass, complete, touchdown, Riverview. Rams look to be going for two. It's looking to pass. And it is incomplete. The two-point conversion is no good. Here is this touchdown pass. With 33-14, Knights have an awful lot of work to do if they could come back in this game. Mekhi Johnson goes out of bounds, across the 30. Off Dallas Sims in the backfield looking to get somewhere, goes out of bounds, first down. Unusual to see Dallas Sims in the running back position. Now Antoine Raymond is back there. Pass intended for Brandon Coupe, a little too high.
And that'll bring up third down. It'll be third and one.
Second and ten now. Second and one, actually. Quarterback keeper, Joaquin Cavuclis. There is a timeout on the field. It's an injured Ram. Looks like that could be a cramp. It is still warm out here tonight.
Well, the emergency 10 tonight to throw in 48.
Pass. Looking to Dallas Sims. And they're calling it good.
And they're going to say he caught it.
Good.
Great catch by Dallas Sims.
That is a very big play from her team. Giant throw to Dallas Sims, and they called it good. That is some very large momentum for them. That is now a handoff to Antoine Raymond.
Antoine Raymond.
Close to
a first down. Antoine Raymond, first down, just short of the goal line. There is a flag.
Rams may have had too many men on the field.
Looks like the Rams had too many players on the field, maybe. Knights will decline the penalty, obviously. First and goal, Knights. Antoine Raymond.
They'll hand it off to Raymond, and he's going to go nowhere.
There's no gain. Second and goal.
Second and goal. All he's needed is 3 yards.
Harry Clough makes the stop, and he's second and goal.
He's passing. Brandon Kube, touchdown Knights.
Number 7, Brandon Kube, for the Knights touchdown.
That is a Knights touchdown, and it is a good one.
Knights are lining up for 2 points. Direct snap, Khalid Campbell, just short, no good.
With
9:58
to go in the
fourth quarter. 10 minutes left in the game. 9 minutes and 58 seconds left in the quarter. And
in the game. Dale Turkey, number 98, making the stop.
Score is now 33-20. Rams hold the lead by 13 points. Which is approximately 2 touchdowns and a touchdown. To win. To tie it, we need 2 touchdowns and an extra point. We need a little bit of a miracle. A lot of skill.
That carry kick.
Onside kick.
An onside kick attempt by the Knights is recovered by the Rams.
First and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
9 minutes, 54 seconds left.
Number 32, Lincoln State with the recovery.
Very close attempt.
Hand off.
DJ Johnson, the ball carrier.
Good run by the Rams. First down.
Second and five coming up.
Second and five now. Hand off. No gain this time. Second and five. Third and five. Third and four. Enough. Kiari James, TJ Wilson in on that tackle.
It'll be fourth down and three.
Fourth and three. And looks to me like the Rams, let's see what they're going to do. Offense is staying on the field. Be very surprised if they weren't going to punt this ball. That's going to be a delay of gain penalty now on the Rams. They did this on purpose. Just wanted to run the clock down before they punted the ball. Seven minutes and 26 seconds left in the game. Punts off. Mekhi Johnson let that go. Very good punts by the Rams. Knight starting from their 19-yard line, first and 10. Obviously, Knights needing two scores here will have to move the ball very efficiently. They are passing Mekhi Johnson. Second and three now.
Second
Khalid Campbell making quite a move. Picks up a first down. Pass. Mekhi Johnson, incomplete.
First down, we'll bring up second and 10. We are looking for Johnson.
Second and 10. Looking for Mekhi Johnson again, incomplete. Third and 10. Hand off Antoine Raymond. Antoine Raymond is a missed tackle. He's going to go score. Touchdown Knights.
Antoine Raymond to the end zone.
32. Wings are still up, but this is one step closer to making this comeback.
What a run by Antoine Raymond.
For an injured Ram.
That is an incredible run and touchdown by Antoine Raymond. At least 6 minutes and 9 seconds of the game left.
You can see 6 minutes, 9 seconds left in the game. Looks like the Knights are kicking, which makes sense. 2-point conversion would not make sense here. It's up and good.
The extra point is up and good with 6:09 to go. The score now, Rams 33, Knights 27.
33 to 27, Rams are up.
I think in this situation, 6 minutes is really plenty of time. Knights need a good defensive set. Most likely they're going to kick it, I would think, kick it deep. Jack Perry out to kick it. And the Knights probably should not be looking at an onside at this point, but they do have their onside kick specialist out. who is Jack Perry. And he is kicking actually a bloop kick. Rams called a fair catch. So the Knights strategy there was to kick the blooper, which usually is not very returnable, but if it bounces wildly, it can always get recovered. So it was a safe form of an onside kick, and Jack is extremely good at that.
Don't forget, coming up at the conclusion of the game, it will be the regularly scheduled halftime show for the best band in the land, Riverview High School Guilty Band Halftime Show. Coming up at the conclusion.
What kind of a miracle here that this is only a one-score game at this point, because it looked like a blowout not that long ago. It's a handoff. Good tackle. C.J. Cresser tripped him up. Second and seven for the Rams. Five minutes, 40 seconds left in the game. Hand off, Sean Civilano with the tackle.
It'll set the Rams up with third down and three after a pickup of four.
Third and three, important third down upcoming for the Rams. Quarterback keeper, very close to a first down. They are spotting him across first down Rams. Four minutes, 15 seconds. Clock is running. First and 10 Rams. Rams are taking as much time as they can. Try to drain this clock. Handoff. Big run on first down, second and two.
Down at the 38-yard line. By number zero, Milano Cloud. The second down and two.
Hand off, that's a loss. Big tackle, Sean Civilano again.
For a loss of two on the play. And the Rams are going to be faced with third down and four.
Three and five. Third and a long four. The Rams are calling a timeout.
Two timeouts remaining.
We now have 2 minutes and 25 seconds left in this game. The score is 33-27. We need a touchdown.
2 minutes, 25 seconds, as you could see on the screen. When the timeout is over, the Rams will have a very big third down play. And off, and he goes out of bounds. Fortunate for the Knights, stops the clock.
34-yard line.
Fourth and nine, obvious punting situation now for Riverview. The Knights are going to have a fairly good shot at tying or winning this game. Makai Johnson back deep to receive the punt. There is 2 minutes and 16 seconds left on the clock. It is stopped now. Makai Johnson is tackled. There is a flag. That is not a flag. It is a block in the back against the Knights. Gonna push them back. Two minutes and 6 seconds are left. Hand off Antoine Raymond. And he goes out of bounds, stops the clock with a minute 59. Second and five. Antoine Raymond, and he is met at the line of scrimmage. 3rd and 4, a minute 35. Brandon Kube, and he is tackled inbounds. Timeout Knights. That stops the clock with a minute and 16 seconds. It is fourth down for the Knights, fourth and three. Obviously, the Knights need a touchdown, but first of all, they need a first down.
Ball at the 36-yard line. Fourth down and three.
Hand off Antoine Raymond, and he is stopped. And this will probably be the game. It is a turnover on downs. Knights only have two more timeouts. There's a minute and 11 seconds, two timeouts. That means that probably the Rams will be forced to run some plays. There is a remote possibility the Knights could get the ball back with a few seconds. Ball is loose. Have no idea who... Knights are saying it's their ball, and it is Knights' ball. Will the miracles never cease?
1 minute and 1 second left in the game. There was a fumble covered by the Knights.
Well, you can't say this is not an exciting game. The Knights still retain their two timeouts. 1 minute and 1 second left in the game. Pass. Incomplete. 58 seconds now on the clock.
Second and 10.
Second and 10 now. Looking to pass. Incomplete. 52 seconds now. Third and 10.
And with that incomplete pass, that is going to bring up third down.
Looking to pass deep. Dallas Sims. Incomplete.
Looks like we may have time out of the field for an injured Ram on the far side.
44 seconds. 44.2 seconds left in the game. That was a big play in terms of.
Fourth and 10 now.
That is going to bring fourth down. It will be fourth and 10. It looked like it. They played it well. See, their problem was, though, I hear almost caught the ball because they turned him up to the ball instead of just keeping his hand. It's DB 101, you don't get to the ball. You pass on him.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
The injured Rams player is walking off, so that's good.
We have 44 seconds left in the game. It is fourth and 10.
Big play for the Knights now. Fourth and 10. Minimally, Knights need 10 yards. 44 seconds left in the game. That is going to be a turnover on downs. And unless there is another fumble, certainly the Rams at this point are going to be able to kneel it. Well, the Rams were kneeling it. Knights tried to charge the line. There was an unsportsmanlike against the Rams.
Thank you.
Not sure what's happening here now. For some reason, Knights player called a timeout. Not sure why. Well, the last few seconds of this game are certainly taking quite some time. But when it's all over, unless there's another miracle of some sort, it is Rams 33, Knights 27. Really don't know what's happening. The refs don't seem to have control of this game. Well, I wish we could explain to you what's happening on the field. We don't know.
So fourth down, Rams sending out, looks like a punt team.
I guess the Rams are actually punting the ball.
And Miller's going to run back, and he's going to take a safety.
And the punter ran it back and took a safety.
And Miller ran into the end zone with 1.8 seconds left. So it'll be 2 points. So it'll be 2 points for Clearwater.
They haven't put the 2 points on the scoreboard, but it will on there. We have it's 33-29. And there's less than 2 seconds left in the game. Well, this has got to be the longest last few seconds I've ever had of a football game. In all likelihood, the Rams now, with the safety, has to kick off to the Knights. And the clock will start on the kick. It's not like a kickoff. So basically,
well, this one not over yet. 1.8 seconds left.
Basically, this will most likely be the last play of the game. The Knights will need to score. All right, I was wrong. The clock did not start. So there still is 1.8 seconds left. Don't even understand how this happened, but somehow or another the Knights maneuvered it to get the ball back. Obviously, a prevent defense by the Rams.
One play.
Knights will need to reach deep into their playbook and figure out something they could do here. Final play of the game, barring a defensive penalty. Passing to the end zone. Knights caught it! The Knights caught it! The Knights have won this game. The Knights won the game. I have never seen a game like this in my life. Unfortunately, our replay system is down. Or we would show it to you again.
That right there is my football career. What an incredible ending to this game. That was
the catch by Dallas Sims. And I think there's very little doubt that Dallas Sims, and it wasn't just for that play, but there were spectacular plays earlier by Dallas, and Dallas Sims is the Knights Sports Network Player of the Week. This has got to leave The Rams, in a completely stunned state, never seen a game end like this. Knights win in a shocker, 35-33.
Your final score here on homecoming here at the Ram Bowl, Clearwater Academy International 35, Riverview 33. Coming up next, the Riverview High School Kilty Band halftime show in its entirety.
All right, thanks a lot for watching tonight's game. Don't miss any night's broadcasts or special postings. Subscribe to us on YouTube. Go to youtube.com/Knights Sports Network. Just click the subscribe button and be sure to click on the alert bell. Allow your phone to alert you whenever we go live. All right, our next broadcast will be Friday, October 20th. Against the very, very tough Lakeland High. And we're going to bring that game to you live from Lakeland, Florida, beginning at 6:15 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Again, if you didn't come for this whole game, amazing finish. Knights were down... I think it was about 16 or 17 points well into the fourth quarter. Came back for a miraculous victory. And Clubware says, I missed the play. Was it a Hail Mary? Well, we weren't that far away, but it was a throw to the end zone and a great catch by Dallas Sims. All right. Again, thank you for watching the broadcast tonight. And until our next broadcast from Lakeland, Florida, I'm going to say so long. KSN fam out.
This is Night.